What's up, everybody? This is Carolina Mike, your host for SharePoint in 60 Seconds, where you can get the information you need in the first 60 seconds. And then if you want to stick around, we'll show you a step-by-step walkthrough. Today, we're going to learn how to analyze a folder structure in SharePoint Online and convert that into metadata to help you sort, filter, group things just way, way easier than digging through folders. Stick around. I'm a SharePoint expert, play with data extra. Careful with my hands, cause I gotta use them for work. Yeah, I'm a big old nerd. I like maple syrup on my pancakes. I don't care what you heard. First and foremost, thank you for watching. Thank you for clicking and subscribing. We appreciate your support. Now, here we go. You see these folders here. These folders are containing t-shirt order forms. And we got them grouped by medium, large, small. These are gonna basically be the names of the choices that you make in the first choice column. We're probably gonna call it size, I would imagine. Then if you click inside one of those size folders, you're gonna find other folders for color. And that's replicated between all the other remaining large and small folders. And you're basically gonna say, okay, well, I need a column to represent color. So you're gonna create a color column. And the names of those folders will go as the choices in your dropdown. You get the picture. You're kinda gonna iterate through that process, digging through all the folders to analyze until you figure out what columns you need. You build those columns, and then you can build views based off of those columns. That's it. Short and sweet. All right, so now let's go ahead and dig right into it with a step-by-step process. And we'll walk you through everything from creating a separate view so that you can maintain this look and feel for people who really love this look and feel, because believe it or not everybody is a fan of metadata. So first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and burn off a copy of this view so that we can create one that will give us a line item view of each order form. And in this case, the order forms are represented by Word docs. So we're going to go in, we're going to burn a copy, create new view. Hey, actually, I don't want to do it that way. I want to do it this way. Save view as. It may be old school, but this is my happy place. So we're going to go home documents. No folders. Make it public so people can see it. And then let's make it real. Let's make it really have no folders. So we go here, edit current view. And we're going to scroll. We're going to go to folders. Show without folders. Boom. Got it. Done. So let's go back to all documents. So we're going to analyze this. So what commonalities do we have here? Well, these titles relate to size. So let's create a size column. We're going to go into choice and we're going to call it size. We'll go small, medium, large. Don't need a fourth choice. Thanks, but no thanks. Save it. Boom. Now we got a column to account for this first level. Well, let's dig a little bit deeper. Now in each one of those, we're going to have a black, blue, and silver. So if we go back, so a medium, also black, blue, and silver. So we need another column to track this. Yep, you guessed it. We're going to add a color column. So we'll go with the choice. And we'll call it color. We got blue. We got black. And we got silver. All right, moving right along. Let's see. We dig a little deeper. What do we got? Okay, then we get to the order form. So we're good. We have a way to sort this and filter this. I mean, we're pretty much done. So we can go to the correct view without the folders. Now we're going to have to do some assignment, right? So I guess what we could do is we can go back to the top. Let's go back to with them in the folders. That may help us with the tagging process. So we'll go in here. We'll look in the large. We'll go into here, and so we could see we're in large and black, so we can select that item and we know that everything in this folder. So we could, here, let's make it a little bit more real because this is going to blow your mind. So we're going to say, let's add a new Word doc. Okay. Oh, we'll go Cam. Welcome back, Cam. Okay, we got that. It's saved. We can get rid of this. So we'll refresh here. All right, so now let's say we had a whole bunch of orders for large black t-shirts. We could select them all and we can do a bulk edit over here. And then the color black. And then those all get updated. Okay, so now we just basically iterate through each size. And we're back. Now we've got at least two orders in each of those color categories. So we actually have some real data to actually play with. So I'm going to forewarn you, by the time we're done with this, I have decided that we are going to experiment. We're going to do an experiment live. We're going to implement this metadata framework, and then we're going to ditch the folders. Let's see if we can actually do that. I've never tried it before, so we're going to experience it together. So here we go. First thing we want to do is make sure we get all of our files tagged. And I did that, you know, honestly, I had to put in some work, y'all. I had to dig in. Okay, this is the part about how difficult it is. If I want to find, you know, the black, large black orders, then we got to go to Cam Newton, Jonathan Stewart. We get those folks here. And we got to dig into the blue to get these folks. And I had to like select them and then do that, what I showed you before, for like every group here. So we go back to our all documents, no folders that we created earlier. And it's like, oh, we don't know what's what. Well, we're going to fix that real quick. All we got to do is just add the columns. So we go to show hide. We want size and we want color. Let's go ahead and apply. Okay, wow, it took a little bit more work. When I told you it was hard work to go into each of these folders, all these subfolders and all that jazz and tag everything. Yes, okay, it took a while. But we won't have to do that again if we can get people to tag the files when they upload them. And we'll talk about that in a minute. All right, so here we go. Now we've got everything labeled. We got the size, we got the color. And we know that we've got everything tagged because this is every file. So we can go through and look at all of them. Now, we need to try and see if we can maintain this metadata and get these files moved, maintain this metadata, get them moved out of the folders and into the top level of this library. So what we're going to do is we're going to select all the files and we're going to go to move or copy, and we're going to move to the current library. And we're not going to put it in one of these folders. We're just going to stop right here and we're going to say move. Let's see if it's going to make sure. I can't see why it wouldn't take the metadata with it. I just can't see why. If it doesn't, I'm going to lose it. Okay. So now we should have two copies of each file. We got the file that's at the top level. Here, let's go to folders. We should see the folders and we should see these files. Yep. So there's the files and we have the copies of them in here. So we theoretically, we could go in here and select these folders and get rid of them completely. Delete, delete, refresh. And there we go. So now we're done with folders. So now when you add a new file, you're going to need to just make sure that you get folks on board with adding whatever metadata you want. And if you want to make it required, then here's what I suggest you do. If size is required, you're going to go in the column settings and you're going to make it required. Save. And then if color is required, you're going to go do the same thing. You're going to make that required. Okay, great. Boom. Now here's what's going to happen if someone tries and dump some garbage into your nice, neat arrangement. They're going to go, let's say they make a new file. They're like, yeah, I'm in here. I'm making, yep, this is my order. Like, that's right. And then they're like, okay, I did it. I guess they should name it, right? They're going to think they're playing by the rules. You know, they're going to do that. Yep, I named it. Okay, I'm done. And now I have other things to do that don't involve SharePoint is what's going on. So I'm going to refresh. here, let's sort by modified here. Okay, newer to older, so you can see the new stuff. So, but you know what? I have a meeting to go to, so I'm not really concerned with this required info. So I go do my thing. Well, don't do that. And if you see, you know, okay, let's see who created it, right? We can't see that yet, but we're about to. So we're going to go to column, and you can do this. Any person can do this. If you can see the files, you can do this with the view. You're going to show hide, and you're going to say, who created this? And when did they create it? I need to know. Oh, okay. Carolina Mike, you created this about a minute ago? Well, I'm going to get on Teams and be like, hey, we got some required. No, just kidding. What I would do is I would say, okay, the next person, someone's got to do it, whether it's the person who created it or the next person. Someone's got to do it if you're going to continue to try and keep things organized without folders. So, you know, what happens is it shows up here, or if you have it grouped, it's going to show here. Let's show you what happens if you have it grouped, grouped by size. You're going to see unassigned. Okay. So SharePoint does a great job of putting it in unassigned. So, and those things rise to the top. And if you got required info, you're going to see this. And you're going to have a view that's going to isolate those files called files that need attention. So it's going to be pretty apparent. And then somebody needs to go in there and edit the metadata for this file. And put it, basically you're putting it in a virtual folder, for lack of a better term. And we know, well, we're just going to say, I know it's a small, and I know that the color selection is blue. Saved. Okay. So there we go. Now we can go back to whatever view we want. Well, it's going to be all documents in this case. There you go. It's in there somewhere. Oh, I didn't save this to be newer to older. But there you go. Now it's categorized. Let's just save this view. Save. This is really all documents. And then we can get rid of the all docs, no folders. We can just select it. And then edit. And then we can just delete this. Yep. We have converted from folders to metadata. And there you get left with all documents. Now, I mean, if you want to continue the conversation, we could take it a little bit further to, you know, creating views. So the beauty of it is that before we had to like dig through folders to see stuff, but here, if we want to be able to see everything grouped by size, then we can just do that. And then boom, now we get some quick stats. We know we have a pretty even distribution of sizes here. You can dig as deep as you want, but at least now you got the basics of how you can slice and dice this stuff and how you can easily convert from a folder structure to a metadata structure or methodology. With that, I'm going to say, take it easy. Do the best you can with what you got. Try and smile at least 7 times a day, 700 times a day. And remember, SharePoint rocks, and so do you. Take it easy, y'all. Thanks for watching. I'm a SharePoint expert. Play with data extra. Careful with my hands, because I got to use them for work. Yeah, I'm a big old nerd. I like maple syrup on my pancakes. I don't care what you heard.